believe that these people want to blackmail the Caribbean to legalize homosexual. We know, and here no Canada there so plainly talking about. We down here so in the Caribbean. Talking about we here so in the Caribbean. And we ain't allowing the gays, we gay laws need to be changing and all sorts of things. Listen, we in the Caribbean, right? Barbados supposed to be a Christian people, right? And we are a Christian society, as they say, right? Even though that they don't live it to the fullest, right? Okay, listen. In the scriptures it says, any man lying with a man is abomination. So as like with a woman, it's abomination, right? And we are Christian folk people, and we try to keep up the Christian laws. Why you coming to bring something that is corrupt and want to make it a part of our society and our culture? It's not of any culture, white man. It is your culture. Homosexual is your culture. Stop trying to force your homosexual dumb our throat. Bumba clock jagger punish you, know, jagger drop with a dead, you know. Stop this, you know. Jagger drop with a dead, you know. La mama, come and say something there to these people, call right now, me rotted, you know. Me a vex for that, you know. Dread.
Yeah, brother Bunga Lights. Field Marshal. I was just reading this here, under fire for anti-gay laws. They're saying this the Canadian Foreign Minister, Mr. John Beard, is actually
you don't have no beard. Who say he's Mr. John Beard? You don't have no beard.
He's actually given the ultimatum to the Caribbean islands that either they accept homosexuality and change their what he call anti-archaic laws, anti-homosexual laws, or I guess Canada now is now falling in line with what Britain, the minister in Britain had said. But what I want to say today is this, that they're pushing a law for two men or two women to be able to get married, to have sex, whatever it is that they're saying, and they are saying, not we, because homosexuality to Africa and to black people is a foreign thing. I mean, if you look at almost all the African countries have totally went up in arms and rejected what Britain was trying to push down on under their throats, yeah, in regards to this homosexuality. And then, so when it comes to African people, black people, don't care where they're at, and don't care what the religion they belong to. When it comes to homosexuality, it is something inside of us that tells us that, look, you know, something ain't right here. And when you look at this, I don't want to get into all the philosophical argument about it, that two men, which we know two men can't produce, we know two women can't produce. We know that, so if we're dealing with the natural law of things, we're going to deal with the natural law that it takes a man and a woman to reproduce. Now, the thing about homosexuality is that they're pushing for these laws to be amended. But all along, Rastas, since the 70s, been brutalized. Rastas been murdered. Rastas been because of their hairstyle and because of their liberty. They've been shut out. Doors been shut. Family doors, institutional doors been shut just because of Rastas choose to live their way of life, which is prison. Emperor Haile Selassie I as the Almighty God. Now, according to the UN, this should be an issue. And this is an issue, this should be an issue because it's been going on in the Caribbean. Anti-Rasta been going on in the Caribbean, and Rasta's been suffering because of this for many years. But I haven't heard Mr. Beard or the minister from England, I haven't heard them say a word about what is happening with Rastas in the Caribbean and the utter abuse
England.
In Canada, in England, and wherever they're at. Nobody's speaking about this. So we as Rastas have to speak of this. And we are saying that if you want to push your anti-gay laws, well then we have to push our anti-Rastafari laws. We have to say that, listen, this is time that if you want to deal with truths and rights, Mr. Beard, Foreign Minister of Canada, I don't know if you ever heard of the Ayokobi incident. I don't even know that you know that there are people that's being abused down here in Barbados because of what they believe in. Because of their hair, because of how they look, because of who they worship. and this should not be the case. So if we are going to, don't put the cart before the horse. If we're going to deal with issues, let us deal with the first issue, which is a human rights issue, which Rastas have been going through hell in the Caribbean to be respected, and nobody has ever came. We haven't heard anything from the Prime Minister. We haven't heard anything from people in Canada. We haven't heard anything from anyone in America. We haven't heard anything from anyone in England telling these same governments that either they respect the religious rights of people or you will put sanctions on them. Why would you want to sanction them if they don't admit two men to be together or two women together, but you don't want to sanction them when they actually, when their laws and what they are doing down here is actually killing people because of what they believe in? I don't know too many gays in the Caribbean is getting killed for being gay. That is a fact, but I can tell you there's a lot of people getting killed in the Caribbean because they uphold Rastafari liberty. So we're going to deal with that, and we're saying this. Homosexuality is an issue, is a very touchy issue when it comes to African people. Mr. Beard, when I talk about England, it is an issue that black people on a whole have not accepted and will not accept. So I don't care how many sanctions you want to put. First of all, you talking about sanctions, most of that money that y'all have comes from slavery, free labor. And you want to come back now and say that you're going to place sanctions on the people that you enslaved because they still don't want to accept something or something that you are pushing that is foreign to them. And I think you need to take a look and realize that you can't push your culture on other people. You want to go around the world and push your, and if they don't want to do this, then you want to sanction, but it don't happen like that. And this is why you're seeing so many upheavals all over the planet, because people, you cannot come into people's country and think that because it works in your country that it's going to work in this country. Because you accept it, that don't mean everybody else is going to accept it. I may like cuckoo, another man may not like cuckoo, and I can't force cuckoo down that person's throat, or I can't force something that the person don't like down their throat. So why are you trying to push something, an issue that is foreign to black people? We are not saying that we attacking anyone because of their lifestyle. Whatever a man want to do with his life, every man, Bob Marley said it perfectly. Every man got the right to decide his own destiny. And in this judgment, there is no partiality. So we saying this, right? We ain't saying that we attacking anyone for how they live, but we saying don't put something down our throat and to say it has to become a law. Because if that has to become a law, then it has to become a law that these governments should stop harassing Rastafari. These governments should stop fighting against Rastafari liberty, where we have given so much to the Caribbean. We have given so much in the arts, so much of our labor in construction. Wherever it is, you see Rastas have contributed to the upliftment of society, and they still receive nothing. They still receive utter rejection from all walks of society. And you don't want to address this issue? You got to address it. Listen, we ain't playing no games with this. If you want to really address issues, address it the right way. And we saying we gonna start now, because before there was homosexuality and issues with that, you had issues with Rastafari. There was issues that needed to be dealt with, and you ain't deal with it. England ain't deal with it. Canada ain't deal with it. So therefore, if you really want to be upstanding and show the world that you living by example, we saying that, listen, come in here and investigate in Barbados and the Caribbean and see what Rastafari been going through, if you don't know, but I'm quite sure you know, because all of these ministers and all them work for you, for your government, whether it's England, Canada, or America, all of them work for you, so it's impossible that you don't know. So I'm saying that we need, if you're going to stop things, let's stop it all across the board. Deal with Rastafari issues, and Rastafari's need to stand up, because you got the so-called gays, you got these people standing up, and this is why you could see this is why you could see the foreign minister, he had to stand up, because the gays all over the world is forcing these governments to address their issues. Why can't Rastafari, true money, but why can't Rastafari too force these governments to deal with our issues? Why can't we deal with the issue of Buju? Why is Buju in prison? As Rastafari's, why isn't Rastafari's throughout the region dealing with that issue to make sure that Buju come home, because he's a Rastafari? And the only reason he's in prison is because of a song that he sang that they say that they don't like. Uh-huh. They don't like, and he was judged because of one song.
And he forced the American government and FBI to set him up.
Jack, so we say that these is things that need to be addressed, because a man sing a song. If a man sing a song that he don't like me, you gonna lock him up because he said he don't like me? Of course not. So if Buju sang a song and he says he don't like a certain particular set of people, that is what he feels. You can't judge the man because of that is what he said, and you won't condemn the man. But a man could get up there and say, it's okay, he gay, and he's this and he's that, and nobody's condemning him. Nobody's condemning him. He ain't going to prison because he say he's gay. So why should Buju go to prison because he say he don't like gays? Or you say that's what he said. We need truth and rights. This Rastas deal with. Rastas deal with truths and rights. And if you don't want to deal with truths and rights, England, Canada, or England, Canada, or America, then don't come to us and tell us what we gotta do, because we ain't doing it. We not doing it. Haile Selassie I, live and reign, continually.
All right, Almighty I, Jah, Rastafari, yeah. Haile I, another thing here, right now. YC, here in Barbados, homosexual been going on around the place for years. Remember, as a little boy, never homosexual. And sometimes one or two people might tell somebody something, but you know, I see the boy going chop up the homosexual. Them homosexual, like you see that going up in Canada and say that they're getting harassed down here in Barbados, they are lying. They can't go in bungalows, they can't go in 360 and such. First of all, these men coming here so I even buy food, and I never even so utter a word to them. They come and buy the food and they wait long. I don't have no problem with that, you understand? But they want to make you feel that we are the worst things out here, doing homosexual, the worst kind of things, or discriminating them. Yes, I got a problem with homosexual, but because I have a problem with homosexual, that don't give me the will to go up there so I want to kill a homosexual or shoot a homosexual. Here's a Christian society, as you all know, and we are democratic people, and we have a freedom of speech to say what we like from we don't like. But we don't go breaking the law by going want to kill a homosexual. Homosexual used to be in South Street, have their own thing out there. We have our own party over here, so I mean, you never hear that the homosexual and the Rastas over here clash. We might sing songs that we don't like them. We don't like the thing, because we don't know it's not part of our culture, and it's a foreign culture that is invading, and our minds want to invade, and our minds and our thoughts. I don't want my children growing up. How do you think a child gonna feel that he's going to school, right? And he see a guy drop off this youngster. And then the guy asked him, who's that? He would say, well, that's his mother and father. Two men, a man and a man. And he said that is his parents. How a man and a man could be someone?
A mother and father.
No, you're trying to twist up people, turn people topsy-turvy the way of God, right? And black people are godly people. You cannot come and enforce and say that we must change from God way to the devil way. That's what you're trying to imply, that we must turn from God to the devil. And we are not changing from God, the Almighty, to the devil. Straight up. You understand? So we don't want to see our youth seeing man and woman hug up and kiss. Up in the east, you don't know that you can't walk, but no homosexual can't be seen in the street. You know what I mean? We know up in England you have it in the street. We know up in America, we know up in Canada you have it in the street. But we don't want it down here. We don't want our youth's mind poisoned with that inferior culture. That's inferior to us. We don't like it. We have it but here for years. They have out by the police station at night, they have homosexual out there, so where they are lying, and men come and pick them up and go and do whatever they gotta do with them. You know what I mean? And we don't get in there where you never hear that rest. We don't hear that rastas go and stone them or shoot them or do anything. Tell me a case, if you can tell me a case that we are Rastas do to homosexual, bring that to the table, let me see. I don't hear you talking about when we are being harassed. Police have harassed my place consistently. I mean, for weeks, every weekend. I was the most harassed dance hall in Barbados. The Bungalites Culture Fest was the most harassed dance hall in Barbados.
And it happened to be run by a Rastafari.
And it run by a Rastafari.
Right.
And everybody here, from police, back down to lawyer, back down to minister, yeah, everybody have a family that is a Rasta. Even if he have just have on locks or she have on locks. So when you address this issue, you must address this issue
the right way.
You understand? We don't want you come and blackmail us because of your little handouts or your little funds. That's money that you owe to us. You owe to my four parents. You owe to me. And Claudia not here, and I'm supposed to inherit that. You understand? That's what you gotta talk about. You understand? You owe us. And you come telling us about we start saying homosexual. Oh man, come on man, get real man. We are not being blackmailed by you, Canada, Britain, USA. One love, peace. May you have a good day. May your wife and children have a good day. Bless all good people. Let Jah deal with the bad people, right? Have a great day. Thank you very much.